In the previous videos, we have studied what's mean by electric field and electric field lines. Now, let us go into calculations, and we are going to start with the calculation of the electric field due to a charged particle. Actually, from Coulomb's law, we know that the force between two charges is given by the Coulomb constant K, which is 1 over 4 by epsilon naught, multiplied by charge 1 multiplied by charge 2 over the distance squared between them, and the direction of this force is going from force 1 to force 2, or in unit vector r direction. Now, assuming that Q is a charge which we want to get its electric field, and Q naught is a tested charge. So, assuming that I have a charge Q and I have a tested charge Q naught at a distance r, so the force at this point due to the presence of Q naught, it would be 1 over 4 by epsilon Q multiplied by Q naught over r squared in r direction. In r direction is going from the center of the charge towards the tested charge here. And as we said, the electric field is defined as the force over the magnitude of the tested charge. So, F over Q naught. This means that according to Coulomb's law, the electric field would be 1 over 4 by epsilon naught multiplied by the value of the charge itself, and this charge, the charge under test, Q, over R squared, and in the direction going from the origin or the center of the charge and going in R direction. If the value of Q is positive, this means that the direction of the electric field is going outward from the charge. If Q is negative, it means that the direction of the electric field, it would be going inward to the charge. So, in this way, we can determine the direction of the electric field vector just by looking at the sign of the charge, if it is positive R or negative R. But as a magnitude, the magnitude of the electric field equals 1 over 4 by epsilon naught, the magnitude of the charge, the absolute value of the charge Q over R squared. This is the magnitude of the electric field. If we are going to draw the electric field as electric field lines, we can say that if we are quite close to the charge, the magnitude of the electric field would be great or large. If we are far from the charge, the magnitude of the electric field would be small, and it would be smaller at a larger distance. Effectively, the electric field is inversely proportional to R squared. So here I am close to the charge Q, so the magnitude of the electric field is large. And the direction of the electric field here is the charge is positive, so the direction of the electric field is outward in the radial direction. Here, I am away from the charge, so the magnitude of the electric field is small, and its direction is away from the positive charge. Alright? This is what is the meaning of this drawing. If we have multiple charges, assume that I have Q1, Q2, Q3, and Q until Qn, for example, and it is required to find out the electric field at a specific point. So, in this case, we are going to put a tested charge at this point, and we calculate the force at the test point due to the first charge, and the force at the test point due to the second charge, and so on until the force at the test point due to the nth charge. Then the total force at the tested charge will be the vector summation of the force from the first charge plus the force plus of the second charge plus the force of the third charge until the force of the nth charge. If we are interested to obtain the electric field at this point, we are going to divide this force by the magnitude of the tested charge Q naught. So the total electric field in this case, it would be the total or the net force at the tested charge over the magnitude of the tested charge. So according to this summation, we can say that the electric field is the force at the tested charge due to the first charge over the magnitude of the tested charge plus the force at the tested charge due to the second charge over the magnitude of the tested charge, and so on. And all these quantities are added as a vector quantities. So we are adding the x component to the x component, the y component to the y component, and so on. Effectively, the first term is the electric field at the test point due to the first charge. So this term is E1. The second term is the electric field at the test point due to the second charge, E2, and so on. This means that the total electric field at a specific point is the vector summation of the electric field due to the multiple charges. So we can simply calculate the electric field due to each charge, and by vector summation of these electric fields, we can obtain the total electric field. So in general, if several electric fields are set up at a given point by several charged particles, we can find the net field by placing a positive test particle at the point and then writing out the force acting on this test point due to each particle as is. If we want the net electric field at a given point due to several particles, find the electric field due to each particle and then sum the fields as vectors. Be very careful, the summation here is vector quantity. It is not scale. It is not so simple to add these quantities. It is vector summation. Alright? As an example, here, the figure here show proton B and electron E on x-axis. What is the direction of the electric field due to the electron at point S and point R? And what is the direction of the net electric field at point R and point S? At the beginning, if I am talking about electron and the proton, it means that I have negative charge here and positive charge here. The electron is negative charge, the proton is positive charge. And both of them have the same magnitude. So, this is effectively minus Q and this plus Q, where Q here is 1.6 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Alright? Okay. It is required to find what is the direction of the electric field due to the electron, electron only, at the point S. Here is the point S. If I am looking at the point S and this is negative charge, if I have a test charge, positive test charge here, it is expected that the force between positive and negative electron such that this positive test charge will be attracted to the electron. This means that the direction of the electric field line in this case will be in positive x direction. Alright? On the other hand, what will be the direction of the electric field at the point R due to the electron? Here is the electron, here is the point R. At the point R, if I have a positive tested charge and the electron is negative, so this positive test charge will be attracted to the electron. So the electric field at the point R will be directed toward negative x direction. What is the direction of the net electric field? The total electric field at the point R. At the point R. Here, if I'm talking about the net electric field, I'm talking about the field due to the electron and the field due to the proton. The field due to the electron, as I said, in negative x direction. Now, the field due to the proton. The proton is a positive charge. If I have positive test charge at the point R, so the positive test charge will be repelled from the proton. This means that the electric field due to the proton will also be in negative x direction. So now the net electric field will be the summation of the electric field due to the electron and the electron field due to the proton, and both of them are in negative x direction. Assume that it is minus 3, minus 4. Minus 3, minus 4, it would be minus 7. This means that the net electric field at the point R due to both the electron and the proton, it would be in negative x direction. The question now, what will be the net electric field at the point S? What do you think? Effectively, the electric field at the point S due to an electron, it would be in positive x direction because the electron is negative. And due to the proton, it would be in negative x direction. Because if I have positive charge here, it will be repelled from the proton. But the question now is, what is the distance between S and E, and what is the distance between S and B? Effectively, the distance between S and E is smaller than the distance between S and B. This means that the electric field due to the electron would be larger than the electric field due to the proton as a magnitude. Why? Because the electric field due to point of charge is inversely proportional to the square distance. So, the electric field of the electron, which is attracting the positive charge in positive x, is greater than the electric field due to the proton, which is repelling the positive charge to negative x. So, now I have, for example, 7 in positive x and 3 in negative x. So, the total or the net electric field, it would be 7 minus 3, it would be 4 in positive x. So, in this case, the net electric field at the point S, it would be directed towards positive x, not negative. Okay, all right. In the following video, we are going to show a numerical example about how to calculate the electric field due to multiple point source. All right, see you.